to take me to the Gulf of Mexico. Well, the packing them said we could take him by surprise if we didn't fire a musket, so we looked him in the eye.
Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Two eyes.
Swatch can keep you off my mind. Hey, hey, your dad's mean.
It was a tiny club. Well, it was smaller than this, much smaller than this. It was probably about as big as that end of that room. And we used to get maybe 400 people crushed in there.
No one but you.
Thought it was the biggest thrill in the world to drink a cup of frothy coffee that tasted disgusting.
And of course it was full of kids, these coffee bars, and with guitars, and it was a great scene.
Mama don't allow no skibble playing in here.
Oh, no she don't.
Mama don't allow no skibble playing in here. We don't care what mama don't allow, play the skiffle anyhow. Mama don't allow no skiffle playing in here. Mama don't allow no big bass playing in here.
Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Pharaoh's army don't drown them all. Oh Mary, don't you weep.
Do you see them children?
Be sure you want the one you take. There are two ships awaiting for you to climb aboard. One is the devil's and the other one is the Lord's. And they both make the journey across the sea of life. One's filled with happiness and the other one's filled with strife.
Be sure before it's too late. Be sure
you want the one you take. There are two ships awaiting for you to climb aboard. One is the devil and the other one is the Lord.
flash bang, what a picture.
Lollipop in a Christmas shop. Thanks, Katie.
Everyone was in a skiffle group. There were, I think, one in nine of the male population of Great Britain was in a skiffle group in 1957. And you only had to learn three chords on a guitar, and that was it. And you were a king.
Icons, if you like to call them that, all started off in skiffle bands. People like Townsend and Mick and all the Who and Zeppelin and Page, Jimmy Jeff Beck and Beatles and Stones and like, everybody played skiffle.
Yeah, I said wake up, darling, darling, what me?
Whiskey of England, seated on her left is Charles McDevitt and his skiffle group, and they're going to sing the song they made famous all over the world, Freight Train.
Freight train, going so fast. Freight train, going so fast. I don't know what train he's on. Won't you tell me where he's gone?
To keep things in the same sort of vein and sing you a song from the same period. Brother Leslie?
There's a guy in town who's called Lady's Lover now. Keeps his pockets full of mirrors.
Called Les Bennett's, who was a lead guitarist for Lonnie Donegan's longest standing guitarist, lead guitarist, who was a very innovative guitarist. He certainly played by the seat of his pants as opposed to any recognisable riffs that you or I would know nowadays. But it was very interesting and very inspiring, that's for certain. And this was the last guitar that was played by him. He played archtop guitars throughout his career, some of them quite good ones and some of them not so good, but fixed up with good Diarmond pickups and things like that. They worked well for his purpose. And this guitar was just about to have a pickup fixed on for his use before the poor.
And there was the dustman, which was the
hit of all time, because before the record was even issued, while it was still being pressed in the factory, it was number one in the charts because of the wholesale orders. And that was the first time it had ever happened to an English artist. It only happened in history once before. That was Elvis Presley. Done it with, I think, Hound Dog.
Oh, my old man's a dustman. He wears a dustman's hat. He wears gold blimey trousers and he lives in the council flat. He looks a proper nana in his great big gobnail boots. He's got such a job to pull them up, but he
couldn't. The Bee Gees, for instance, who made their very first national television appearance on Bandstand. This is it.
Oh, my old man's a dustman, he wears a dustman's hat. He wears gold blimey trousers and he lives in a council flat.
Bye-bye, stakeout your claim now on some other gun. I've wined you and dined you till my money's all gone. Now the gold rush is over.
I don't ever know how he could put a show together and keep everybody happy, because he had so many, many hit records. He was in the charts.
They gave him his orders at Monroe, Virginia, saying, Steve, you're way behind time. Steve Brody said...
England's answer to Esther Williams, Miss Diana Doors. Good evening, Diana.
Good evening, Sir Robert.
Please, not here. It's not necessary.
Oh, I'm flattered.
Miss Monroe, arrival of yours, Miss Diana Doors, has arrived in the United States. Is your going to England any just a coincidence, or is it any kind of an exchange arrangement? So we won't be lonesome while you're gone.
Well, I'm afraid not,
Just that, well, I find you so exquisite, and I don't know how I can ever resist you.
Oh, lovely person. Wish I could remember her name.
Sean! Doesn't he always look like that?
Glamour to an almost continuous parade of showbiz topliners, British film star Diana Dawes arrives in Australia for a theatrical and nightclub season. Diana is married to TV comedian Dickie Dawson, and when not on frequent trips home to England, spends all her time with hubby and her two sons at their ranch-style house in California. She freely quoted her age as 31 next birthday.
Along the canal bank, down the mighty Mississippi. We took a little bacon and we took a little beans, and we bought the blooming British in the town in New Orleans. Well, we're buying our gun, and the British kept a coming, and there wasn't as many as there was a while ago. But we're buying one more, and they began to run down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Opened up my muskets and we really gave them. Oh, well, we fired our guns, the raiders kept a coming, and they wasn't not as many as there was a while ago. But we fired once more, and they began to run on down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Well, they ran through the briars and they ran
The Beatles, God bless their cotton socks, came on the scene in 1962, and as they came on, I went off.
Get-togethers as people do, and swapping our ideas over the kitchen as to what was going to make the best, most famous skiffle band of all time. And very shortly afterwards, we got the news from Les that he was terminally ill, and he didn't have long to go. And indeed, he didn't have long to go. It was a very short period from that time to when he passed away. I went to pick up this guitar just before he died, and he didn't have one regret, because he'd had a very good life out of music. The wonderful thing that Les and I shared also, which would probably ruffle a lot of feathers when I tell you, is that we both shared an abhorrence of music being diluted by comedy.
To me this morning, he says, Lon, you're number one on my hit parade.
Number one on his hit parade?
Yeah, then he hit me. Oh. I don't know where he's coming through, but I'm sure. The animals in Australia.
So it's ironical, really. So if you didn't know Les, he was the other voice in My Old Man's a Dustman. So.
What's good for a knobbly head?
I don't know. What is good for a knobbly head?
A knobbly head.
So. He probably went down laughing with that one, and me too.
Come back. Do you realise, do you like the voice?
Yes.
Do you realise there's a man knocked down in London every minute?
There's a man knocked down in London every minute?
Yes, and he's getting very tired of it, I'll tell you.